Welcome, dear friends. This is Dr. B.L. Kumar, and today we are going to discuss about placenta and various types of placenta in different species. So this is the third part of my lecture on concept of development, and we have studied about early embryonic development up to the formation of extra embryonic membranes in our previous two lectures. And here you can see the various stages of early embryonic development at a glance in our these two previous slides up to the formation of extra embryonic membranes. And we have also talked about implantation, that means opposition or fusion of the fetal membranes with the endometrium. Actually, true implantation occurs only in case of rodents and humans, in which the conceptor buries itself into the endometrium beneath the surface and temporarily disappears from the uterine lumen. Whereas, in case of most other species, the conceptor superficially attaches on the endometrial surface and never disappears from the luminal compartment. So once there is implantation, the development of placenta takes place immediately to establish the physiological exchange between fetus and mother. And we have also talked about placenta. It's a temporary organ of pregnancy that provides a medium, an interface for the physiological exchange between conceptors and dam. And the functional unit of placenta is chorionic villus. So here you can see in this picture, this placenta acts as an interface to facilitate the medium for physiological exchange, means the exchange of nutrients, the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide, the exchange of metabolic waste between fetus and mother. It means placenta is a vital organ for fetal growth, and it regulates the fetal-maternal exchange of nutrients, gases, water, ions, and waste products. And this is how this placenta acts as a multitasking organ, since it is capable of metabolic, immunologic, transport of gases and nutrients, excretory function, and even endocrine function. As you can see, in placenta, there is the transport of maternal antibodies from maternal system to the fetus. So it acts like an immunologic organ. Again, placenta mediates the transport of CO2 and oxygen. It means it takes part in oxygenation and deoxygenation process of the blood. It mimics the function of lungs. Again, placenta also secretes some hormones. It means it acts like an endocrine organ, and it also mediates the excretion of waste metabolites from the fetus. That means it mimics the kidney function. So it is a multitasking organ. So now we'll see the various types of placenta in different animal species. But before going into the details of classification, I want to make one thing very clear, that placenta is not composed of only the fetal tissue. It is also composed with maternal tissue. Both fetal and maternal tissue act as placenta. The either part, either fetal or either mother, maternal part, can't be called as placenta. So regarding the types of placenta, there are various criteria to classify the placenta in different animal species. First criteria is based on distribution pattern of chorionic villi. The area of distribution of chorionic villi upon the chorionic sac, based on this criteria, the placenta is divided into five categories. First is diffused placenta, wherein the chorionic villi are uniformly dispersed, uniformly distributed all over the chorionic sac, and this kind of placenta is found in equine and swine species. So in this kind, when the chorionic membrane is detached from the uterine endometrium, it resembles to the Turkish towel in appearance, since it is having the chorionic villi dispersed all over the surface uniformly. The second type is cotyledonary or multiplex type of placenta. Here, the chorionic villi are distributed to the particular areas, particular circumscribed areas, and these areas are termed as cotyledons, and hence this kind of placenta is named as cotyledonary type of placenta. And these circumscribed areas appears just like buttons on the chorionic surface. So cotyledonary type of placenta is present in ruminant species like cow, buffalo, sheep and goat. Next type of placenta is Jonnery placenta. Jonnery, this name Jonnery is originated from the word John, a particular area. So here in this case, the chorionic villi are disposed on a particular broad encircling belt, a broad strap. Only this particular zone is containing the chorionic villi, and this kind of placenta is present in bitch and cat. So if you aware about one strap which is used by fatty people to control the belly, to shrink their belly, and they apply this belt, this strap on their waist portion. So this type of placenta appears to this strap. Later on we'll see in detail the images, real images of Jonnery placenta and each and every type of placenta. So the next type is a discoidal type of placenta. Discoidal, the word discoidal is originated from disc. Disc means a circular structure. Disc. So chorionic villi are confined to a particular circular area, disc-like area, and this kind of placenta is present in human and rabbit. Next is bidiscoidal. Here there are two discs on which chorionic villi are present, and this type of placenta is present in monkeys. The next criteria to classify the various types of placenta is based on the loss of maternal tissue at the time of placental detachment during birth. So here there are two types of placenta. One is deciduate and another is non-deciduate. So deciduate is also called as placenta vera, and here, as the name indicates, deciduate means there is the loss of endometrium at the placental detachment during parturition, and this kind of placenta is present in dog, cat, rodent and human. Another class is non-deciduate or indeciduate or adeciduate. Here there is no loss of maternal tissue during parturition at the time of placental detachment, and this kind of placenta is present in cow, sow, ewe, goat and mare. It means the loss of maternal tissue depends on the level of proximity. How tightly the maternal and fetal tissue are bound with each other, are attached with each other in the placenta. So it indicates the level of proximity, and that will determine the loss of tissue at the time of detachment. In case of deciduate placenta, there is tight relationship between the fetal and maternal tissue, and hence there is loss of tissue, endometrium, during the placental detachment at the time of parturition. Whereas the bonding is very superficial in case of ruminants and equines, and therefore there is no loss of maternal tissue during placental detachment. The third class is based on the degree of proximity between maternal and fetal blood circulation. How close fetal blood approaches to the maternal blood, and this is determined by the recognition property the phagocytic property of trophoblast or chorionic epithelium that may be exerted on the tissue with which it comes into contact. Means the chorionic epithelial cells, they are having phagocytic property, and this phagocytic property varies among different species. Means some of the epithelial cells in the chorionic membrane, in particular species, they are having more phagocytic property, and hence they engulf, they eat the more and more maternal tissue. So fetal blood circulation, fetal capillaries, they reach very close to the maternal capillaries. So here in this classification, placenta is divided in five types. First is epitheliochorion, that is present in mare, sow and camel. Next is synepitheliochorion or syndesmochorion, it is present in ruminants. Endotheliochorion, this is present in bitch and cat. Hemochorion, that is present in primates, and hemoendothelial, that is present in rat and rabbit. So here there are basically two terms: epitheliochorion, synepitheliochorion, endotheliochorion, hemochorion. Means these two terms, they are derived from maternal side. So the prefix epithelio, it represents the maternal side, maternal layer of the placenta. Here chorial word, it represents the fetal side. So prefix indicate the maternal side, there is the suffix indicate the fetal side, and we'll understand in detail the meaning of these terms, epitheliochorion, endotheliochorion or hemochorion, in further slides. So this type of classification is based on the histological layers in the formation of placenta. So let us talk about histological details. Here in the first image, you can see the union of maternal side and fetal side. So if you count the number of layers which are acting as barrier between maternal blood and fetal blood, you can see, you can start from the maternal side. Here this is the endometrial capillary, and blood is flowing in this endometrial capillary. So first barrier layer is the capillary wall, or it is called as endometrial capillary wall. This is also termed as endothelium, endothelial wall. Now the second barrier is connective tissue, a layer of connective tissue, and it is called as endometrial interstitium. Here the name is given in this list. First is endometrial capillary, second is endometrial interstitium, and the third histological tissue layer is the endometrial epithelium. On the fetal side, the topmost tissue layer is the chorionic epithelium. Next to this chorionic epithelium, there is a connective tissue layer which is called as chorionic interstitium, number 5 on the list, chorionic interstitium. And lastly, here there is fetal blood which is flowing in the chorionic capillary. So it is bound with the capillary wall, and it is termed as chorionic endothelium. So total there are 6 layers in between the maternal and fetal blood. In next type, that is endothelial. Okay, before that, here the name epithelial is given based on the tissue layers which are directly close to each other, directly attached to the each other. So here you can see on the maternal side there is endometrial epithelium, whereas on the fetal side the chorionic epithelium is making close contact with the endometrium. So epithelio-chorial, chorial means chorionic epithelium. So here there are maximum 6 layers in between the maternal and fetal blood. In the second type, endothelio-chorial. So here you can see the fetal chorionic cells are directly attached with the maternal blood capillary, that is the endothelium. Capillary wall is termed as endothelium. So this type of placenta is named as endothelio, since prefix is indicated from maternal side. So endothelio-chorial means chorion, endothelio-chorial. In the next type, hemochorial, in this type the chorionic cells, they are directly submerged into the maternal blood. So that's why it is termed as hemo, hemo means blood, and chorial means chorionic cells. So here I want to make your notice on one common thing in all types of these placenta, that the maternal side of layers, they are reducing or they are varying in number, whereas the fetal tissue layers, they are intact, they are constant, they are three in every type of class. Here in epithelio-chorial there are three tissue layers, another endothelio-chorial there are three tissue layers on fetal side, and even in hemochorial there are three tissue layers on fetal side. So this determines the phagocytic property of fetal chorionic epithelial cells. These epithelial cells, they are having phagocytic property. So based on the level of phagocytic property, they eat, they engulf the maternal tissue and they reach very close to the maternal blood. And depending on the barrier layers in between the maternal and fetal blood, this kind of placenta, this kind of classification is done. Now we will see the species wide details of placenta. So the first is placenta in ruminants. So first we will revise the types of placenta on all criteria, based on all criteria. First was based on distribution pattern of chorionic villi, that was cotyledonary or multiplex type of placenta. Based on the loss of maternal tissue at parturition, and on this criteria the ruminant placenta is termed as non-deciduate or adeciduate type of placenta. The third classification was based on the histological structure, and based on these structures the ruminant placenta was termed as epithelio-chorial or syndesmochorial. Better to say syndesmochorial. There is a minor difference between epithelio-chorial and syndesmochorial, about which we will go into details in further slides. So here cotyledonary type of placenta, it indicates the union of cotyledons, which was the fetal side of placenta, and caruncles, that is the maternal side of placenta. So the union of cotyledons and caruncles is termed as placentomes. So here you can see the first image in cow. When you cut open the gravid uterus, So this is the uterine wall, and this is the luminal surface, which is composed of endometrium. And immediately you will find the fetal sac, which is composed of amniotic sac, in which the fetus is contained directly, and the another is chorioallantoic sac. And on this chorioallantoic sac, you can see some circumscribed areas, button-like areas, and these are termed as cotyledons. The fetal side is termed as cotyledons, whereas the corresponding maternal side is termed as caruncles, and the union of caruncle and cotyledon is termed as placentomes. The similar type of assembly is present in sheep and goat, but there is little bit difference in the cotyledons of cotyledon and caruncles, means placentomes of the bovines and sheep goat. In case of bovine, the placentomes are convex, whereas in case of sheep goat, these placentomes are concave, means they are depressed in the central area. So in ovine placenta, you can see this is the chorionic membrane, and which is making a close contact with the maternal caruncles. So this particular part is called as chorionic stalk. CS means chorionic stalk, and here P represents the placentome, the union of cotyledon and caruncle, placentome. And here you can see the blood supply through the umbilical cord, using this umbilical cord, and here it is composed of umbilical vein and umbilical arteries, which are going into the placentomes for exchange of various physiological materials like nutrients, gases, metabolic waste, etc. As I told, there is difference between the placenta of bovine and the placenta of caprine and ovine. And if you see the endometrial surface, which is represented by this fan color, and it is forming a tree-shaped structure. So this dark colored tissue is the chorionic tissue, means fetal side. So the union of endometrial surface and the fetal chorionic membrane, they are making a mushroom like projection, means this placentome is protruded out of the surface, whereas in case of sheep goat, this endometrial surface, this endometrial epithelium, which is represented by this faint color, it is somewhat concave or cup shape, and therefore this projection is having a central cavity. Although it is also protruded out of surface, but it is having a central cavity and it is forming a cup shaped structure. So in sheep goat, the placentomes are concave shape, whereas in case of cattle and buffalo, and even in giraffe, the placentomes are convex shape. And in these real images of conceptus, you can appreciate the shape of placentomes in case of bovines and in case of sheep goat. The placenta is clearly cup shaped. Although placenta of sheep and goat is concave shaped, but again there is a minute difference between sheep and goat. Here in the first image, you can see the placentomes of the goat, and in the second image, you can see the placentomes of sheep. So just by appearance, you can appreciate the difference of these cup-shaped structures, these placentomes, that here in case of goat, these placentomes, this concavity is more dominant, more prominent. Whereas in case of ovine placentomes, these cavity is very shallow. So these concave placentomes are not as much prominent as in gut. When we talk about the time of placentation in ruminants, the attachment of chorion with uterine carunculus begins at around day 16 in case of sheep, whereas at around day 24 in case of cattle, and it completes at around day 30 and 40 respectively. So when the vascularization of the chorion through allantois is completed at around day 40 to 60 in case of cow, the allantochorion is ready for the participate in placental function. Means now placental function will actually start at around day 40 to 60. It means before this time, before this 1.5 months, how this embryo is nourished, since placenta is not ready for its physiological function. So before that time, before the development of vascularization and development of the functional capability of the placenta, the embryo is entirely dependent on the uterine milk, on the uterine environment for the nourishment through diffusion via chorion and amnion. So when we observe the fine details of ruminant placenta once the vascularization is over, so here this purple colored structure, this purple colored layer is the chorionic layer, allantochorion. So you can see the chorionic villi, here there are three villi. So this is as a whole, this is one villus, and this is the second villus, and here this is the third villus. So in individual villus, you can see there is the tuft of capillaries which grow out from the allantochorion into the crypts of maternal caruncles, and they embed into the, these villus, they are embedding into the crypts of maternal endometrium or caruncle. And again, this caruncles, these are also having the plexus of maternal capillaries. So here you can see there is close contact in between the fetal capillaries and the maternal capillaries. So there will be exchange of nutrients, there will be exchange of gases and the exchange of metabolic waste, and exchange of the antibodies, exchange of the some other factors like hormones in between the maternal and fetal blood circulation takes place through diffusion. Some processes are active, some processes are passive. And from here, this blood is carried by the umbilical vein towards the fetal heart. So here you can see there are two umbilical arteries which are carrying the impure blood from fetal body towards the placenta for its oxygenation and excretion of the waste metabolites. And this is how this impure blood is purified, oxygenated, and it is again swept back towards the fetal heart through the umbilical vein. There is a single umbilical vein, whereas there are two umbilical arteries. Now we will talk a little about the histological criteria of placenta in ruminants. So as we have already classified, this type of placenta in ruminants is termed as syndesmochorial placenta. Now, the word syn indicates together, and desmo means cytoplasm. For example, synchrony, syn means together, chron means time. means together with respect to time, synchronization of esters, synchronous means together with respect to time, and desmo means cytoplasm, syndesmo means the cytoplasm is together with each other. So soon after the embryonic attachment, there is a formation of syncytium on the maternal side. Here in this image you can see on the maternal side, this is the maternal side, there are some different kind of cells which are having 2-3 nucleus. So syncytium, the word syncytium indicates a single cell or a cytoplasmic mass which is containing several nucleus, multiple nucleus. So this may be formed by the fusion of two or more cells, or otherwise incomplete cytoplasmic division. There is only division of the nucleus, but there is no subsequent division of the cytoplasm. So there is formation of multinucleated cells, and these type of cells are called as syncytium. And here you can see most of the binucleated giant cells, they are forming on the maternal side at around day 14 in case of Eve and day 18 to 20 in case of cow, and they remain forming till the term, up to the end gestation. And that's why this type of placenta is named as syndesmochorial, means these are the syndesmic cells, syncytial cells, and which are making contact with the fetal chorionic epithelium. So this prefix syndesmo and suffix is chorial, fetal chorion, syndesmochorial. And these binucleated giant cells, they keep on migrating from cotyledon to maternal caruncles. So these binucleated giant cells, they also play important role in endocrine function. Placental lactogen are supposed to be secreted by these binucleated giant cells. And apart from placental lactogen, there is a specific substance that is called as pregnancy associated glycoproteins. And there are two pregnancy specific glycoproteins, PSPA and PSPB, pregnancy specific protein A and pregnancy specific protein B. So PSPB is secreted by these syncytial cells. And this PSPB plays very important role for early pregnancy diagnosis. So here you can see these syncytium, it is derived from the trophoectoderm and the endometrial cells, and they constitute about 20% of the fetal placenta because they are migrating to each other. Now if we talk about the number of these placentomes, there are 70 to 120 functional cotyledons in case of cow, whereas 90 to 100 functional cotyledons in case of sheep. And these are arranged in four rows, two dorsal rows and two ventral rows along each uterine horn. So here you can see the caruncles on the uterine endometrium and the corresponding cotyledons, means that is the fetal part, chorionic part on the chorionic membrane. So the chorion and this following allantois, means chorioallantois, it extends into the non-gravid horn also, and thus it is quite common to be numerous functional cotyledons in the non-gravid horn also. So this is all about the ruminant placenta, and now the equine placenta, about which we will talk in detail in our next lecture. This is all for today. Thank you. Thank you everyone. Thank you very much.